Toot that thing up, mommy, make it roll. Once you pop, pop, lock it for me, girl, get low. If your mama gave it to your baby girl, let it show. Once you pop, pop, drop it for me, maybe we can roll. Oh!
Pop, lock, and drop it. 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 Pop, lock, and drop it.
Tonight is gonna be some pain. There's no access to dick.
Hello, 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 my Scorpio. All right, and welcome to February and February's forecast. All right, let's get into it, y'all, because it is, I'm excited to get into the reading. I really think this month is going to be, I'm hearing a month of pause, okay? It's not going to be a month where you're super zooming forward, you know, and like, really, really, like, pushing forward and jumping leaps and bounds and all these things. I think you're in preparation for that. I think Pisces season is going to come in and bring more benefit. That's your sister sign. So coming into the end of February, and March is going to be more where you're in your prime. But what I'm seeing right now, and I honestly think that you get that. You know, you feel that within yourself that you kind of want to be a little bit more, you know, a little more chill, more Scorpio. I did kind of that, you know. You want to be a little bit more... reclusive or introspective. You're zooming into situations. There's two cards that we got in the reading that deal with taking a break, getting fresh air. So this could be a time as well where you're either planning on traveling, or you could be traveling or getting out to a new place, going on a walk, you know, that you've never done before, hiking, you know, or just adding some kind of outside adventure, or even it could be like yoga or some kind of meditative, where you're outside of your home, okay, where you're outside in nature, where you can take a break, okay, where you can release, all right. And so I really think this month is going to be a lot about, you know, the things that come in your reflection, what answers you're getting, okay. Starting off the reading, guys, we got the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. So I instantly was like, okay, Scorpio's in a little bit of a stop, okay? You know, maybe a project this month you're going to be doing a lot of revisiting, okay? Re-seeing things, getting your mind figured around things, okay? Aquarius season is also squaring your energy. It's a 90 degrees away. And so it's Aquarius season can be difficult for Scorpio, okay? Like Scorpio season can be difficult for Aquarius, okay? Because it requires lots of balancing energy that's not necessarily harmonic with your energy, okay? Aquarius and Scorpio do relate in the way that they're both fixed signs, okay? So that, you know, they both handle situations in the same way. They both exert energy in a similar way, have a similar mentality. But they're two completely different elements, okay? So it's literally like yielding a completely different element that's foreign to you the entire season, okay? So you're in a bit of a pause this coming into February, all right? And we're really looking into certain situations this entire month that kind of have you feeling a little bit, not left, I'm hearing left out, okay? It could even be left out if you're feeling left out. But I'm really thinking as well as it's like battered and wounded, you know, it's situations where, I mean, a couple other signs are feeling this as well. Capricorn is going through this a little bit. Sagittarius as well is going through this as well. Where there's still an attachment to wounding from the past. There's still feelings like, you know, certain bad situations are going to occur again. Or like the universe has it out for you. You know, this is kind of these energies, okay? And so we're working now this month to shed these energies, okay, to find forgiveness, acceptance, and objectivity, to see the purpose and why things occurred, okay, to gain new faith and new trust to move forward, and then towards the end of the month, you will get a lot of, I see the New Beginnings card, so it's literally, we'll get to it, okay, but I started to pull, I was like, okay, let's see what's going on with Scorpio, we got the Hangman out, so another card of energy of pause, okay. Hey man, he can't work right now. He's hanging. You know what I'm saying? But through the sacrifice, the Hangman's about sacrifice. So this month you might have to sacrifice a lot of your time you would use to be productive, okay, to reflect, okay, or your energy level might be lower. And so Spirit is like, no, we're going to sacrifice a lot of your energy, okay, so that you can reflect. Sometimes you never know with Spirit, like there's so many times when I'll have plans and then somehow they'll just dissolve. Like I'll either get super, super tired or someone will cancel or the train I'm going on will randomly not work and I can't get there. And then I end up coming back to my place and later on there's a major realization I have through just because I was here and reflecting, okay? But that wouldn't have happened if I would have gone on that plan, okay? And so Spirit needed to throw a little wrench in the system so that I could actually stay home and reflect. So this could be your energy this month. There could be a lot of roadblocks, okay, slowing you down. But it's so that you can stay on this peg and reflect, okay, and get a new perspective on situations. Because this, the Hangman, is he's not necessarily, it could be him hanging to get new perspectives on the future. But I really think a lot of it is he's looking at what's already happened and getting new perspective, okay. Seeing the world as it is upside down is the present, okay. So there's really a looking at your past situations, not from a place of, battered syndrome, like, oh my gosh, look at all this happen. I'm glad I barely made it. It's going to, oh, this is, you know, life is so hard, so much work. That's going to weigh you down in the future, okay? It's about finding new perspectives, an optimistic approach to the future, okay? And it literally, I pulled clarity for the Hangman. I got the Tower, okay? So this is a major, major foundational theme. This is something that Scorpio's been dealing with for a long time. Okay. Anytime you feel like you're moving forward, there's always a part missing. There's always something missing in your fulfillment. Okay. And what I'm seeing is it's a disempowerment. Okay. From past situations. Okay. It's a feeling like, you know, you might be in the job you want, but it doesn't still feel right. You know, you might not get the power you need, okay? You might not get to speak your mind the way you want. You might get stepped on, okay? Or you might be in a relationship you want, but you're not, again, in the energy you want. It's not the exchange you want, okay? You don't fully get to express yourself in a way. It's too much sacrifice for you, okay? It's always something, you know? Finances, you work into your finances, but it's gonna have, you have to put in so many hours, so much work, and blah, 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 blah. Anytime you try to push forward, there is some, to get this fulfillment, something comes in, I'm sorry, to get the fulfillment, something comes in and you're like, it's almost there, but it's not there, okay? But what it is the way you see situations, okay? Every time, because we're constantly manifesting, we are you know, co-creators with the universe, okay? And so basically, anytime you're dreaming of the future, if it has anything to do with the energies of, oh, this is going to be so much work, or, you know, you plan to get a job, but it's like, let me get this job, I'm, you know, I guess this will work, you know, it's the most practical job. You're not dreaming of your ultimate job, because subconsciously you fear that that'll even come happen. You're like, oh, that's not going to happen, or I'm not even worth that, or I have to put in too much work for that, or that's never going to happen. Let me dream this thing. So subconsciously, you're already sabotaging it because it's already filled with doubt, okay? Or filled with, oh God, you know, let me get a new job. But I hope it doesn't have the same situations as before. What is going on? Lord, that siren is not going off, okay? Oh, it's coming closer now. Oh, hello. Jeez. Oh, okay, it's an ambulance. Okay. Sympathy, okay. Let them do their thing. Go ahead and get what you gotta get. Okay, I'm sorry. I was thinking it was police. I'm like, y'all are aggravating, okay? I'm not, you know what I'm saying. I'm not like total, I'm not trying to, never mind. But it's ambulance, okay? I definitely, but it just was going on for a long time. I'm like, oh my gosh, like, I can't even focus. But if your intentions are not solely pure, going forward, your manifestations are not going to be solely pure. And so then at the end of the day, you're like, ugh, every time a situation happens, it ends up halfway not working out. I don't end up feeling these ways. And it's because it's not the universe has it out for you. You're dreaming from a wounded place a little bit, okay? It's a place of restraint, you know? And so that's what you're going to get back. You know, you always get back what you send out. And so Spirit is taking this month to really pause and allow you to reflect on your inner voice, really listening to, I really see there's a creative project. And Scorpios, you're so creative and so artistic and strong-willed with that, okay? And it comes from such a deep, deep place. But I really feel like there's been so much doubt, like, oh, no one's going to vibe with me, you know? But no, you literally, in your art, as this is you, as you're doing your thing, you get all kind of guides helping and moving with you, okay? Scorpios are literally like walking portals. Just guides are always, spirits and, different entities are always around you, okay? Using you, and you're inspiring them, and then just co-creating all the time, the inner voice, okay? Notice another being speaking to her, okay? But there's a need to really get fresh air. It's also what this could be with this creative project. And because it could be you just feeling like restricted with it or frustrated with how things are turning out. But it's because as you're going forward and dreaming and working, it's again from a place of not what if, but only if, okay? Not, oh, what if this happens? That'll be so amazing. But it's like, okay, only if this works this time, I'll be able to get this. You know what I'm saying? Right, hold on, I'm going to get a little dropper. So there's really a need this month to take some fresh air. I even think that it could be take spending more time with family to just get you in a place. Remember I was saying a little bit earlier, a place where you can relax, you know, where you can just go and just not think of much and release yoga or going out in nature, okay, is going to be really, really great so that you can just, surrender a little bit more, okay? Yeah, there's definitely an expression. Anytime I have readings and I get this kind of stickiness in my throat that comes randomly because it was not there before. The radiator is also cutting on, but I really think it's a deep place. I'm like, I can't, it's not going away. There's something that's not being said or there's something not being expressed in who's listening, in the reader, okay? Or the person getting the reading, okay? And so I really feel there's a deep passion. I'm really feeling my gut now is even tense. Deep down, guys, okay, that you have, you're building something creative. This is something, you know, creative within yourself, just a new self-love, a new project, a new business, entrepreneurship, okay, something artistic. You could even be pregnant, okay? That you're really passionate about, and it's really causing frustration that it's maybe not going off the ground like you'd like, or, you know, you're not getting it. It's not, again, not fulfilling in the way you're wanting, okay? It's not coming in the way you want, okay? And so I really feel tension now, okay? And that need to really express and get it out, okay? So I really think also what I'm getting to, the block could be the family as well. Maybe the fresh air, you're not able to get fresh air because you could have limitations from the family. Or maybe, you know, this feeling like, you know, you're the one left out or that kind of thing. Notice how your family treated you growing up, okay? My dad literally used to, even until I was in high school, when I'd come downstairs, excuse me. Yeah, you got to clear your throat, y'all. Get it out. He'd be like, did you brush your teeth? Did you wash your face? And I'd be like, I'm 19. Like, why are you asking me this? I'm not retarded. Like, oh, I hate when I say that. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? Like, I am able to survive on my own. I'm not three. Okay. Or, you know, when I first moved to New York, okay, on my own in college, I was like the top 10% of my class. Okay. I got all A's. Honors, AP classes. I was, as doing that, doing dance, you know, as well, driving. And I also worked at least one job outside of teaching dance, okay? So I had a lot on my plate when I was home. So why would they think that I would not be able to manage anything when I would move away? That's my personality. This is, you raise someone who knows how to handle themselves, okay? But my family treated me literally like I couldn't even feed myself. They kept asking me, so did you buy groceries? Are you eating up there? Do you know how to get around? Have you, you know, I'm like, okay, yeah, I got lost a few times and all these things. Yeah, that's normal. But I'm not sitting here like, oh my God, I can't leave. I don't know how to get anywhere. No, like, I'm fine. I wouldn't have moved here if I didn't know what I was doing, okay? And so I initially, and now that I'm getting older and looking back, I even then, even though I was bold enough to move up here and was strong in myself, a lot of the beliefs I held in myself were their beliefs. I saw myself as they saw me. Okay, like I couldn't do anything and that kind of thing. So then when I had these big dreams, I actually was sabotaging them because I saw myself lesser than my true potential. Okay, if my family growing up were, you know, again, it's not about shifting anything, but I'm saying if I heard more of, oh yeah, you can do anything. Look at what you've already done. That's nothing. Just keep doing it. Keep, you know, look at our family line. We've done this. Look, you're a human. Look at what your race has done. If there's more encouragement you've heard, that's going to be natural to you. I'm like, oh, of course I can do this. There's no problem. I love, there's certain little young dancers I teach where I'll be doing a new move, okay? And they're working on it. And some of them will be instantly like, oh my God, this is so hard. I'm not going to be able to get this, okay? And I'm like, no, it's fine. Like, keep working. You'll get it, you know? You got this. Notice them like before. And then I have to keep encouraging them because it's different personalities, okay? Some were like me when I was little, okay? I was more nervous and like, you know, very hard on myself. And I had to be like, to those, you know, little kids, I'm like, look, you got it. And Lotus last week, remember your splits last week? You are more flexible now. Look at how far you've gone, girl. Okay. You're going to get this next week. You're going to be like, oh my God, that was so easy. Okay. And then they were like able to like try again. And so it's about giving them new imprinting, allowing them to have new beliefs of themselves. But there's also dancers that don't even bother with doubt. They're like, oh, this is easy. What is it? Okay, then they might mess up and they're like, I gotta keep practicing. Practice makes perfect. I'm not gonna get it right now. I'm gonna keep working and then I'll get it. And I'm like, yes, exactly. You'll get it. Perfect. So they already have a strong belief system. So when they get my age or when they get your age or any age, you know, then they already know they don't have to worry about, you know, having these doubts in their manifestations. They're going to manifest purely because they don't doubt themselves, okay? So that's what I'm seeing, you know, Scorpio. I really think that maybe in the family situation, there could be limitations there. But family is what I'm seeing came with fresh air, so it could be that you either need to get fresh air from them or being around them could be like fresh air, okay? I'm not saying your family, like, be suspicious of your family. And you would know, you know, okay? If they're limiting in that way. So just check and see if that has been an influence. Maybe that's something as well. I didn't even realize until I really looked into certain patterns that I'm like, dang, why did I not see this in myself in the past? Why did I not, you know, see these things for myself? Okay. And it's because they weren't acknowledged until later on. Okay. Well, next card we got is acceptance. So again, taking all these situations in the past and finding acceptance and forgiveness for everything. Okay, I really think though, like I said before, you know, spirit's already around you and always wanting your betterment and helping you out. You got trustworthy guidance coming in, okay? So this month, you're gonna have a lot of guidance, a lot of energies here to help you. And the card beside that, I pull clarity for, open your heart. Okay, because it's, and that came right underneath creative projects. Okay, so there's a real strong need to, whatever I was focusing down, the look at my throat is gone, and I'm talking more. You would think my throat would get drier, okay? It's gone, okay? It's clear, okay? So there was something very passionate that before we talked about it, I think we might be resolved working into it, but you feel very strongly about something. It's deep in your heart, and so Spirit's really trying to allow this opening in your heart and allow to, but it's, your heart is nervous to open because your mind is telling it all these bad situations are going to keep happening or it's not worthy of it, or, you know, oh, this could happen. Oh, the universe is not, it's not a good environment, all these things. Okay. So it's not going to open up. Okay. But what I'm seeing is by the end of the month, notice the white in this card, the purity, the clearing, the innocence happening. Look here, the next card. New beginning, all white, pure, okay? Leaving the shadows of the old behind as he walks into this new environment, okay? So there's definitely this need, and it honestly looks like the same character. He has wings here. So maybe this is him, okay? And you, basically, okay? So moving into complete newness by the end of the month, I really think you're going to be walking to a new beginning by Pisces season. But it really is using your mind during Aquarius season and your inner voices and the things you hear. As an Aquarius, it all is, you know, we rule the higher, the heavens, and we rule kind of like, we're like antennas, okay? And we always have these aha moments, okay? Uranus is our ruler. If you're in any transit near Uranus, it's revelations occurring, sudden changes, sudden aha moments, okay? Because it's an antenna. Aquarius is connected to the cosmic energies going around. So whatever we pick up, we receive. It's like, oh my gosh, okay? So use that. Whatever you're picking up, okay? Whatever guidance is here and flowing in, it's great support. You got trustworthy guidance. It's moving in to really help move you forward, okay? And I really, really see that. And then after we got new beginnings, take time to breathe. I really think this month as well is going to be about taking time to breathe and release and taking time to calm the nerves and anxieties and realize, you know, those situations that occurred were growing. You know, they needed to occur in that time. And it also affected other people in different ways, okay? If you feel inclined, watch the Sagittarius video. I talk about that deeply there as well, about how, you know, one situation, yes, we're not isolated at all. If one thing occurs to me, something else has to also be occurring to something else. There has to be, you're not independent, okay? So any situation you're going through that could have occurred, okay, where you felt left out, there was also something occurring on both energies, okay? Like I spoke with in the Sag video about I'm going through a realty situation, and I found out I was going through all kind of stuff with this. And then it ended up where we're just, they ended up not, you know, canceling, and we're not even going to do it at all. And I'm like, oh my God, like, why did I go through all that? But no, I had to learn a lot about trust with people, who not to trust, because I instantly went in too trusting and too open, and that showed a side of me that, you know, there's a lot I learned. And also, I think they learned things, too, about how to deal with people. Because a lot of it was, hey, you need to be genuine. This, I'm a human being. I'm not a robot. Okay? We need to have compromise. We need to... There's a lot of things that initially did not work that I was able to, you know, work with them. Okay? You got to work with me. You have to work with my schedule. We need to be more accommodating. Okay? All these things I was sharing, we both learned. Okay? They wouldn't have felt like they could be overly empowered over my schedule and over me if I wouldn't have been openly just, oh, anything goes in the beginning. You know what I mean? So it's about looking at the situations from the past and seeing from a new perspective what really went down and why situations turned out the way they went. Okay, not just because the universe wanted to screw you over. That's not what happened. It actually has been growing you the whole time. Okay, so there's new beginnings, lots offered this month, my Scorpio. Last advice card, the ocean. Again, another natural energy. So maybe going to the beach or clearing in the bath, in water. Really energies of getting out and releasing, okay? I mean, this is also energy of the ocean, talking about going with the flow, okay? Literally the entire ocean, there's not one part of the ocean, okay, the water part, of course. Now, the land underneath the ocean and stuff, that's separate, but it's all connected, okay? The wave that we see on the shore is the same vibe that's following deep, deep, deep down under. The way the ocean is moving in one massive just vibe, okay? And so it's all connected. So go with that flow. Go with the flow of the collective. That's how we all are. We're all moving together and waving. If you've been to New York City, you know, and you look at the subway and how people just... But when you feel like you're trying to be isolated and you don't go with the flow, you literally bump into so many people. You have to follow the flow, okay? So that's kind of what Spirit's showing this month, because there's new beginnings coming, my loves. All right, my Scorps. That's what I have for you guys, okay? If you're a new Scorp and you're tuning in and you like my vibe, go ahead and subscribe. Thanks for watching for the first time. If this hit a chord with you and you want to go deeper into a situation, you want to, you know, remove this voice that you're hearing or remove the, you know, the see deeper into where situations came, especially family situations, okay? Hit a reading up. Check out my services. The link is always below. That's what I have for you guys. Always thank you for staying tuned and, you know, being on my channel. I really, really appreciate it. It really means the most to me. And I just love sharing with you guys. And yeah, okay. Much love, guys. Deuces. Enjoy the month of February, my Scorps.